guys. I'm gonna make this presentation extremely informal, and it's not the use of a lot of social media jargons. And probably I have a lot of questions for you guys as well. So if I could start understanding that better before we proceed. I feel, you know, having worked with Fujifilm for about 2 years, we managed their complete turnkey marketing solutions, and we just encounter that we are in touch with so many photographers on a day-to-day basis, and we give them cameras for review. But I felt this gap where the photographers are really great at their work in terms of photography, but the other step, or the gap of actually marketing the photography or giving exposure to the photography, is something which is missing. So I thought it would be a good exercise to actually get in touch with photography clubs, speak to you guys, and actually get an understanding as to when you click a photograph and when you edit it and put it up, how much of an effort actually do you take in terms of marketing that? I understand photography always does not have to be commercial, but if I make a particular thing which is really nice and I do not let anyone else know that it's really nice, I feel like we're wasting a lot of our talent. So how many of us have a blog here, a photography blog? Okay. And how many of us, our photography is the career for us? All right, for the rest of us, it's passion, it's just a hobby. All right, and would we say, are we an amateur photographer? Have we just gotten into photography, or this is exactly what we have been doing since a good amount of time? Do we consider ourselves as a seasoned photographer?
Yes.
Seasoned? All right. And how many of us are active on social media? I'm not talking about your updates in terms of where you just had lunch or dinner, but actually how many of us have created our pages and are dedicated enough to update it? Yeah? And what about the rest? Do you just feel Twitter is, I don't understand Twitter, it does not make sense, or do you feel like I don't have enough time to actually go about doing social media to market myself?
I understand.
Yeah?
Twitter,
no. So everything is just Facebook, and apart from Facebook, it's still a hazy. So you're using Google Plus? Lovely. Okay, fine. Great. So have we all downloaded these apps? Yeah, most of us? Lovely. So we're going to be talking about social media for photographers. Now, what we will be covering in this quick presentation is going to be how to market your photography via social media, how to set up a blog, tracking your digital influence, and social commerce. This is something which I can go on for hours and talk, but I'm just going to have a quick overview as to how it goes about, and if we feel that we want to get a better understanding about a particular subject within this presentation, we can always have one more workshop just to go into detail on one of these aspects. Now, when I thought about photography for yourself, you're a brand. So it's not just about your photography, it's about you as your personality as well. So you need to figure out if I'm a portrait photographer or whatever kind of photographer I am, how are you marketing yourself as a brand? If I see your Instagram profile, or if I see your Twitter updates or your blog posts with your style of writing, I should get an understanding as to the person you are, and people who want to work with you should be excited enough to work with you. So it's not just about your pictures, but it's about you as a whole. So you are the brand, you are the packaging itself. So how we want to go about it is, social media is going to help you in terms of brand building. You might be attending these Photo Walk Dubai workshops from time to time, but apart from this, if your photography is only limited within this network of 800 people, suppose, and you're not actually active digitally, you will not be able to let other people know the kind of photography that you're doing, the kind of network that you're doing. Probably a potential opportunity that awaits you would be hidden. So we want to talk about brand building, managing relationships. So suppose you just had a client, or you just did a workshop or a photography project where you were working with a brand. How would you make sure you nurture and give the due credit to the brand that you are working with this brand, the brand feels that brand has got exposure from your project as well. How to manage relationships, or within here is a relationship as well, with Photo Walk Dubai and you guys. How much after this workshop do you actually share photographs with each other? I'm not aware how much we do, but apart from Facebook or apart from 500 pics or whatever, is there any other way that you share your photographs on a day-to-day basis and say, hey, I just went to Somalia and this is the things that I clicked and what do you think about it? Did you write a blog about it? Did you get people to tweet about it? Or when you were at Somalia, did you actually tweet and say, this is my location, this is where I am, this is what I'm doing? And so both would say, oh, nice, that's pretty cool, for, you know, this is what I'm doing right now. So we want to manage relationships in a way that we want to get a conversation happening apart from Photo Walk Dubai just being an offline event. It should also be a constant online communication, even if you guys meet once a month. Direct sales generation, for some, photography might be commercial, for others it might be passion, but impassion as well. Suppose if we took the construction workers of Dubai and their scenario. If you would actually go and do a photography of the construction workers of Dubai and hold an auction or a CSR activity where we would want to raise some funds, do we actually know how do we raise funds or make money via our photography? So we would do that via social commerce. And apart from that, whether we use any of these social media channels, it's really good Google juice. Google juice, I mean, if you have all your channels active and I just type in your name, I would get links and links of your work without you actually doing much of an effort of being an IT expert. So it would be excellent for social media, search engine optimization ranking. And more than anything, sometimes we feel that a certain photograph is really good because we clicked it. But at times you really need that sort of feedback and inspiration from other people as to what they thought about your photography. So social media is more about a conversation where you can actually say, hey, what do you think about this? I clicked it XYZ. And someone will say, I think you could use these features or this setting and, you know, have this photograph work better. So it's more of a collaboration. The channels that we're going to be concentrating on today is going to be a blog. The reason why I make a blog so important is, imagine you have a shop and in the shop you have your products. So without having a property, for me the blog is your property, without a blog or a website. So without having a blog, you don't have any place to actually showcase your work. So you really need to show that dedication and time in terms of your passion or your career to create that website. Many a times we create the website and we're so excited about creating that website. We spend 2 months on it. Once the website is created, this excitement fizzles out. We forget about it and we say, you know what, I don't have time to update my blog or my website and I don't know how I'm going to do it. So a blog is an area where you're going to create the content and make sure that this content is then seeded on Twitter, Facebook, Pinterest, Google Plus, and Instagram. So how are we going to manage our content? I don't want to have a blog or a Facebook page which is hard selling and it's all about me. Look at the photo that I took. I did this. I did that. But rather say, hey, what do you think about this? By the way, this is a tip I found. Why do you guys feel this kind of helpful to you guys? An opinion poll from time to time which you could use. Creating a video out of the photograph that you took to show the inspiration that you had, or also adding a personal touch in terms of behind the scenes pictures. So suppose if you were just having a photo shoot at a beach probably, and you would take a picture and Instagram and say, hey, you know what, this is where I am, watch out for the images that are going to come up soon. So a person will start feeling that, you know, you're a person who's actually taking this seriously and you're showing the whole packaging of how you're going to go about your career or your passion. And become an authority. Have the guts to say, or have a sort of an authoritative opinion to say, I think you should use XYZ settings, or you guys know it better, you know, this is a new trend, or this is what is happening, why don't you guys try it out? Probably my perception to you will change because you're not only showcasing your photography, but you're also giving an opinion about photography. So all of these things are very interrelated. You see that the website and the blog are the center of everything. Apart from that, there's going to be Instagram, Pinterest, all of these things linking in together. So that does not mean that you took a picture and had a caption of it and you took the same caption and pasted it on all the channels. That is being lazy. So a Twitter is 140 characters. The way to write a tweet is going to be very different because it's just 140 characters and you need to sell in those 140 characters. As opposed to Facebook or Google Plus, it's more pictorial. So you would use pictures and keep the number of words minimal on Facebook. So, but this is more in terms of you put some content up, you get an understanding of what kind of content works for you, you see your analytics, and you figure out on which post did I get most number of comments, and you'll always feel the posts on Facebook with the least amount of words will always get the most engagement as opposed to you writing a story there. Instagram, of course, you know, with all of this, the use of hashtags is extremely crucial. So if we understand how to use the hashtags, which we will in a bit, we would get a better understanding on how people can search the work that you have done. If I'm going too fast, please let me know. Or if there are any questions in between, you can always stop me up. So, for those of us who have a blog here, on what platform have you created a blog?
WordPress.
It's the best. And it's the most easiest, and anyone can understand this. There's nothing technical about it. You can always customize it according to your requirements. And we suggest to use a WordPress blog as well. But make sure that the WordPress blog is customized in terms of the look and feel to your work. Now, suppose if I made a WordPress blog, I want the same look and feel on all my channels. So I should not have a different logo on one channel and have an oversized logo on the other one. The consistency of our brand, we are a brand. So the consistency of the look and feel of our brand should be the same across all the channels. So we would use a WordPress blog. We could customize a blog. You should always buy a domain for your blog, so that it looks a lot more, you know, serious as opposed to wordpress.com/whatever. But rather actually have it as your name, photography. But if you use the word photography, again, for search engine optimization, it's really easy to search your blogs better. Content updates, give that dedication to yourself and that commitment to yourself that as soon as you take the step, when you take the step of marketing yourself, be sure of how you're going to do it. Don't just put one foot in and say, I'll create my blog now and I'll create the Facebook page later and I'll do the Instagram later. But when you're getting in, then go all in to actually get the full effect of social media marketing for your work. Content updates could be, I mean, you know, I just heard before this someone saying, I don't like writing much because I'm a photographer, so it's all about the photography itself. It's not about writing much. You don't need to be a good writer to maintain this blog. But even that inspiration, which just has about 3 lines or 4 lines of, you know, what you thought about this photography, of why you took this photo, that's more than enough. And let your work be more pictorial as opposed to being a lot in terms of content or words. Apart from this, you could also use a video blog. If you're comfortable recording it and letting people know rather than writing it, that's fine as well. Or use infographics to tell, you know, how you thought about this. So that's content updates. A good blog that would be updated would be at least about 4 blogs a month would be a decent count. But if you feel 4 blogs is too much, even 2 blogs could be a good start. Link to the content with social media channels. Within the blog itself, you might have certain links to external channels. So you can make sure that you link these so that people on other channels come to know about your blog. So suppose Subodh has a blog right now and he wanted, Fahad to write about a certain something as a guest blogger on your blog. That really helps because Fahad is going to make a bit of noise and say, hey, you know what, I wrote on Subodh's blog, check out this link. So you guys are mixing your blogs with each other and integrating it, so the amount of exposure that you're going to get from each other's blogs are going to be way better as opposed to the blog just being all about yourself. So get that connection happening and that networking happening. I'm a little too anal about Google Analytics, even for my website, for McCollins Media website. I sit down every day and just go through how many visitors came on the website, from where did they come, what keywords did they use to search my website. If you feel like the keyword portrait photography is what's getting you more hits, probably till the time you initially build up the number of hits on your site, talking about portrait photography will be better for you. You know, you can understand on which pages of the blog did people go and how many retweets did a particular blog get. So we're going to start off with Twitter. How many of us have a Twitter ID here? And how active are we? Yeah, that's the thing. Because everyone says, hey, aren't you on Twitter? You say, yeah, you know what? I've created my Twitter ID, but I'm not active on it. So do you just feel, what are you doing right now? 140 characters is useless. Like, why do you care? What am I doing right now? Or do you just feel, I don't know what to talk on Twitter? You don't know what to talk on Twitter. So what you need to do is make sure that if you're actually taking this whole thing very seriously, you use Twitter more for work as opposed to saying, you know, some people vent out their emotions on Twitter, which I always find very weird. But either if you are wanting to be professional, then don't mix your personal life into the Twitter feed. And make sure that it is just professional. And when it is professional, like, I don't remember the last time I hired someone seeing their resume. I've been hiring people seeing their Twitter feed seeing their digital, profile of how they are. And that's the same thing. If I'm going to check you out as a photographer, and if I want to hire you for a project of mine, I'm going to go ahead and see what you're all about. Do I have fun working with you? What's your personality all about? So your Twitter feed could be more about links of 5 tips to take photography on XYZ, or it could be, this is where I am right now, or Subodh and 10 other people having a conversation about a certain something, or as simple as, if you don't know what to talk on Twitter, use search on Twitter, which I will show you in a bit. Search photography Dubai and see the conversations that are happening with the keyword photography Dubai, and jump into a conversation where someone says, I'm really bad with photography terms, but if someone says use XYZ exposure and this is going to make the picture better or something around that, or hey, check out this picture of Burj Khalifa. So you can jump into the conversation and say, oh, which lens did you use or which camera did you use? Initially, try to make the conversation a little bit more open-ended, where you're asking questions so that the other person feels the need to reply back to you as courtesy and gets back to you and says, hey, you know what, I used XYZ features, and this is how I went about it, or this is where the location was, so that you start connecting with people. And on Twitter, something which is very nice is creating lists. There's a thing called private lists and public lists on Twitter. When I show you Twitter, I'll probably run you through what are the basic features of Twitter and how can we go about it. So Twitter is mostly, I created a blog post. I used the link of that blog post. I gave a good caption on Twitter. I put the link and I started tweeting about it. I think the excitement will be when you see retweets of those links, you feel like going ahead and writing another blog post, because you get so excited that people within Dubai and internationally actually liked what you wrote about, and your work is not enclosed within this room, but it's actually spreading internationally. Be reactive. So suppose a certain something in terms of a natural disaster or a celebration or New Year's or whatever it is that is happening, be reactive, where you pick up stories or trends which are happening as of now and go ahead and do a bit of photography on that. Take those pictures and share it online with the hashtag of that trend which is happening right now. The chances of your work being picked up is going to be way higher. Now suppose all of us, this is an event, we are at the event, and if we would be active on social media, we would be live tweeting at this event saying, this is what is happening, this is what we're talking about, XYZ, using the hashtag or the ID of a Fujifilm or a Canon or a Nikon or whatever it is. How's that going to help you is, a Canon and Nikon are going to start picking up your conversations and are going to start taking you seriously and telling you, thanks both for tweeting XYZ. You know what, why don't we meet up for coffee another week and actually think on how Canon or Fujifilm can work with Subodh. So people who you feel you wanted to get, acknowledged by, they would start acknowledging you at an event. Suppose if you start seeing the hashtag of the event itself, even though you don't know who's sitting next to you, but with that hashtag, you can start recognizing who are the people next to you and conversating with them. Google Plus, especially for UAE, it's not active at all. But we still love it because it's very niche within its thing. I always say that Twitter and Google Plus is more intelligent conversation or more niche conversation, where people are sharing about their hobbies and things of this sort. Google Plus has a massive display for images, so you don't feel like the quality of your images when you're displaying it is getting cut off or it's getting hampered. It works really well. There's a thing called creating communities and circles. Now, if you feel like food photography or fashion photography, or you're breaking down the verticals of photography, you can actually break it down and search people who are doing those sort of photography, connect with them and get it done. You can also get in touch with fashion brands, food brands, if you really want to get in touch with brands to make a conversation happening. Google Plus is good for sharing knowledge and events, and Google is being a bit biased and helping with search engine optimization as well, of course, why not? So that helps you as well. In terms of a few tips for Google Plus, I always say upload a decent picture, because personally, when you use your own brand, you'll end up putting a pixelated picture or something which is cut or not right. So put a decent picture. Post regularly with variations of content that you're going to be uploading. Don't only post links of your blog, so have a multimedia mix or a content mix. And don't be the silent types where you posted one thing and you're waiting now as to how the conversation is going to happen, and then you're going to say, you know what, I told you, social media does not work for me. But don't only be on your page and wait for people to come to your page, but get onto other people's pages and go ahead and comment so that you can start getting them to know that, you know, you're around as well. And stay on topic in public. Now, in terms of Instagram, we always say for Fujifilm, we were always considering, does it make sense for Fujifilm to open an Instagram account? Because we do not believe in iPhoneography or, you know, smartphone photography. So what we thought was we would use Instagram more for behind the scene images. You don't want to shoot with a DSLR or a proper camera, which has good quality, and then go ahead and shoot, you know, you say that Instagram and everything is for amateurs. So you show behind the scene pictures on Instagram, what are you doing? Or suppose we are there at this event, take a group shot, put it up on you know, Instagram and say that this is where I am right now, this is what I'm doing. And thank people for the shoot, become a little bit more personal, tag people on Instagram, that helps you as well. So again, these are all, you know, ways of connecting the dots and creating the network. So that's our Instagram account. As much as we have a few people and a few birthday celebrations, we also, you know, create a sort of content on Instagram which would be very little words and more pictorial for it to be picked up. The reason why I put Facebook page in the middle, and Facebook is not the only priority to your social media activities, I feel Facebook is more of a place for leisure. I'm going to go on Facebook, I'm very distracted, I'm going to see a few other ads which are going around, and I'm just going to put up the content. And I don't even know who's coming to my page, and I don't know how they are reacting to my photography. But of course, everyone's on Facebook, so I have to be on Facebook as well. So Facebook can be used more for creating events and, you know, putting up pictures. But don't put albums of pictures, put one picture and explain what this is all about. There's no point on uploading a lot of images. Finally, Facebook has given us a breather with the use of hashtags. So now hashtags which are used on Twitter, Instagram, Pinterest are now available on Facebook as well. So you can actually create your own hashtag. So that would not just be photography, because if I type the word photography and search for you, I will never be able to find you, because all the people around the world will be using photography. So how can you create a hashtag which is very specific to your work, so that if people start using that, they would be able to search you. Facebook is good for taking feedback, using a lot of multimedia mix in terms of videos, opinion polls and things of this sort. And open-ended content really works very well for Facebook. How many of us are on Pinterest? Oh, that's pretty interesting because I've never heard many guys being on Pinterest. The demographic always shows that a lot of women are on Pinterest for the fact that they love food. The kind of things that, yeah, the kind of things that work on Pinterest is food and fashion. And photography, good, it works definitely if you're into food, fashion photography. That works really well. So, you know, on Pinterest you create boards and put up the pictures there and everything of that sort. But I would always consider Pinterest to be phase two after you're fully active on social media with Twitter, Facebook, Instagram and all of these other channels. So on Pinterest it would be just more of a display, but there's no conversation much that is going to be happening there. And right now, especially within the Arab region, Pinterest has not picked up as much. Now, as much as all of these other social media channels were very conversational or your personality like, LinkedIn is something which is, if you're looking into commercial photography, your LinkedIn profile has to be updated at all times. Don't be lazy and not write what type of photography that you do or where have you been working. Go ahead and, you know, write that complete content which would be helping you. If you have this 500px or any other portfolios, make a slide share of these portfolios, put it up there so that people could actually view your portfolio then and there rather than exiting your profile. And if your photography is extremely commercial, you should make a company page on LinkedIn as well so that people can search. You know, normally the culture has become such, you get a business card after the person leaves, you type in the person's name and you pretty much scan, probably because I'm into social media, I do that more often. But you scan and you see what the person is all about, what are the connections that that person have, who are the people that they're working with. Try to coax a few of your networks to give you a few testimonials on LinkedIn so that you have that and say, hey, you know what, it's really a pleasure working with you and this is the work that we did and the project turned out to be really good. That makes me feel a lot more comfortable and confident working with you. I would call hashtag a magic because it pretty much spreads the word around. So if, you know, I would use this here and say the first tweet up and say I'm in McCollins Media for the Photo Walk Dubai event with Meghna Kothari, that would just get me limited number of tweets or replies, but my tweet would not actually reach to a great audience. As opposed to, I'm saying I'm at McCollins Media for the Photo Walk event with Meghna Kothari, with hashtags IGERS, Dubai, UAE, digital, photography, add hashtags as much as possible so
what
that,
is,
huh?
Is IGERS?
It's Instagrammers. I know, I'm insane.
I have no clue.
It's Instagrammers, and there are 1,000 variations of that, but IGERS works best. So if you don't feel comfortable with IGERS, it's fine. But go ahead and start putting things like Dubai Media City or Burj Khalifa or the place that you're shooting at, the venue that you're shooting at, so that those people would definitely, if they have their marketing teams, would definitely say, oh, you were at Burj Khalifa and you were shooting and this is what you were doing. They will keep you in mind for their events and start calling you. Now, measuring your influence, you always say, you know what, this is a lot of stress. Why do I put so much time and effort in actually putting, you know, posting every day and doing these efforts? How do I know if this actually works? Socialbakers.com is a fantastic tool which integrates with Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn and all your social media channels. It costs about $99 per month as a subscription, and every day it gives you a sort of a report and tells you how many comments did you have, how many shares did you have, how many people commented, from where were these people, how often did they visit your blog and things of this sort. Because if you're really serious about photography and marketing it and in terms of increasing your business, then you should be serious about seeing the analytics and figuring out how does my marketing actually work for me. Apart from that, a few KPIs which we always see for all our clients are, you know, how many likes, how many shares, how many hits, how much exposure, comments, but this is something we can slowly get into, and cloud score. So social commerce is a newly, you know, coined term. It's basically, how do you make money out of social media? Social media is great for engagement, but many brands ask us constantly, how do I make money out of social media? How does this work for me? So if you feel like you're having an exhibition, you've gone ahead and worked on you know, a photography project and you want to have an exhibition where you want to exhibit this work, firstly, you'll use Facebook events to make sure that you have good attendance. Apart from that, you would make sure that, you know, you have an app or a widget or something where you have it on your Facebook page so that people could actually, you know, get a sneak peek into the sort of photography that you're going to be showing on the inspiration, have a sort of a CSR angle to it where you would auction it, or also have a PayPal account integrated into your website where people could order prints of the photography that you're doing. Now, this is extremely commercial, but if you want to go that route, you could definitely look into that, where you've done this whole spade work effort of creating good amount of Google juice for people to find your work. Now that people have found your work, it's probably time to encash this work that you're creating. So you would rather, you know, have PayPal accounts and everything built into your blog or your website where people could order a print of a particular photograph that, you know, you clicked or you liked. So this is one way of going about it. You could also invest in Google ads, YouTube ads, Facebook ads and LinkedIn ads to promote your page so that more people can come to this particular sales point of your website. So this is all about you. One more aspect which is left is about becoming a brand advocate. You know, some of us are extremely passionate, I would like to hear about Fujifilm, but apart from that, there are other brands like Canon and Nikon which you might be using cameras of, and you feel like a few of us here, we are just passionate about photography and we really don't care about selling anything or making any money out of this. So for those who are passionate about photography, do you feel you would want to be in connection with Nikon, Canon, Fujifilm to get a sneak peek into a new product that is coming, or to get your first hands on a particular product that is coming? Do you guys wish that could happen? Yeah? If that's something which you need to do, then you need to start hashtagging Nikon, Canon, Fujifilm, creating your blog, you know, reviewing a particular camera, telling them about that particular camera, and yeah, that always happens. We need to do something about that. Sorry. So you need to, you know, use hashtags so that the Nikon Middle East team or the Fujifilm Middle East team starts getting in touch with you guys. So when you're uploading your pictures, use these hashtags so that they can start connecting with you. So here we gave this camera, you know, the X100S, to Maria. She is she's taken the Fujifilm X Pro 1 on a 1 year lease from Fujifilm, and she's doing a 365 day project where every day she's giving a picture for Fujifilm. And she's taking these cameras, but constantly she keeps on tagging Fujifilm and says that, you know, I'm at this place and this is a photograph that I have taken, or this is the review, this is what I thought about it. So we always make sure when we have any event for Fujifilm, we don't forget to call her. She is on our mailing list. So similarly, if you feel like any of the brands that you are passionate about, you want to be in touch with them, be a part of the workshops that they're doing, start communicating with them so that they feel that it's important to have you on board as well. So this was pretty much it for my presentation, but I wanted to just take about 10 minutes to go through the apps itself and see how we could use these. How many of us have tried a Google Plus Hangout? And why did you try it out? I mean, how did it work for you?
Personal.
Yeah. But how do you think a Hangout would work for your photography? So suppose if there's a photographer that you know, you follow in US who's really good, and you might want to get in touch with him here, you might want to, you know, do a Google Plus Hangout, which is a group hangout or a party hangout where a photographer in US and UK and other countries would actually connect with you and tell you, and you guys could have a conversation or a debate about a certain something in terms of photography. But it's just personal again, in terms of just having a conversation, which is a video conversation. That's pretty much it. So this is Twitter. Now, I mean, we all know that, you know, this is where your Twitter feed comes, these are the pictures that you put up, this is where the people that you're following, and lists. So I'm gonna click on list right now. And here we have quite a few lists which are made of technology bloggers, top media people in UAE, potential clients, whoever that we feel we want to make a list about. Why do we make a list is because as soon as we make a list, we don't want to, suppose I just wanted to talk about portrait photography and I did not want to talk about anything else, and I would be only following a few people who are specialists in portrait photography, my list would only show photo bloggers here who I would only want to conversate about Fujifilm too. So in this feed of mine, I'm not getting people who are talking about food reviews or other things which don't matter to me, right? Do we have any questions? I mean, this I wanted to be more conversational. So if you guys feel like you have any questions, please let me know. Sometimes you create certain lists which are public so that you feel like you're giving another person that appreciation of having them in your list. You know, they get a notification that you have added them onto their list. So top photographers in Dubai. And if you added me as a top photographer, I would actually like you because you thought I'm a top photographer in Dubai. You know, I'm just saying. So similarly, you could always have public lists which you want people to see, and private lists which you can name it as you want. But these lists would just be of those people you want to keep a tap on or know what they're doing. But that's about it. Now, I'm just going to show you how the search option works. If I type photography, so I just type photography Dubai. It showed me something about Samsung and XYZ and the people who talk a lot about photography. And if you felt that any of these tweets was interesting, suppose Daniel Chong, all the time he keeps on putting fantastic pictures about Dubai, and he's been getting a lot of heat in terms of Nikon. So if I would actually like what he's conversating about here, I would follow this person, I would jump into the conversation and I say, that's a stunning picture, thanks for sharing, how did you go about it? And that person would, you know, then start noticing you and start conversating with you. So this is how you build your network. Now apart from lists, if you feel that, you know, there are certain things which are trending, which show on the discover icon, where you come to know that what are the trends that are happening. Here you see trends in terms of Dubai, Blessed Friday, Instagram. There are always these random weird trends that keep on happening. But if you feel any of your photography matches a trend that is happening here, and you use this hashtag to then tweet, the chances of your tweet getting a lot of retweets is very much high. I feel for any of these channels, you just need to be open to making some mistakes and meddling with it. and then you get a hang of it. I mean, as much as this is a workshop where I'll be telling you that this is how you can do it, but till the time you actually don't get your hands on it and try it out, you'll not be able to understand it. So that's a little bit about Twitter. In terms of Pinterest, this is pretty much what it looks like. So for McCollins Media, we've made boards about the team, public relations, social media, and whatever else that is. Similarly, for yourself, you could make boards, hashtag it, and pin it on certain things. Pinterest is something which you need to make sure that you get on Pinterest every day and actually update it rather than forgetting about it, then you're not going to be getting much exposure. But that's pretty much on Pinterest. But if you see, being a social media agency, unfortunately, we just have about 76 followers because it's really not picking up in this region much. There's not much about it, unless and until if I would talk about a Samsung or a bigger brand that would anyways catch enough fire. Now, something which is most interesting I'm going to show you right now is Instagram. This is what Instagram looks like. And we keep on sharing things on Instagram, but what Instagram did yesterday was fantastic. They launched Instagram Video, which is great. So suppose I'm going to be taking a picture right now, so you guys see yourself here, and I want to make it a video. So first I take a picture, that's great. I can take, use the filters that I want. I'm sure you guys as photographers really don't like using filters of such sort or apps of such sort. But if I would just go ahead and here, I would type as many hashtags as possible here to make sure that this photo gets searched on Instagram very easily. I'm not going to type it out right now, but this would be a good way to go about it. I think on the projector it's not showing the video option, but the video is such, if you guys have used Vine, where it makes you take videos and tap each time, so you can actually create a video and say this is where I am right now, and this is what this event looks like, or give a video footage of that event as well. If you feel like you're very comfortable in terms of YouTube, then you can make a YouTube channel as well and be a host on the YouTube channel and actually talk on how, give 5 tips about YouTube, or Subodh is right now making a time lapse on a certain something that he's done for a photography project. So rather than being so monotonous of just putting up content, you can make video content about it and put it up as well. Any question, guys?
Hashtags.
Yes. This is exactly how you need to communicate it. So suppose in every event of yours, when you made that event, you need to start yourself using Photo Walk Dubai as a hashtag, and probably at times when you want that hashtag to be most searched, have a competition around the hashtag. So yesterday we launched the Samsung Galaxy Zoom, and we had the hashtag Galaxy Zoom S4 Dubai, because of course we wanted to be searched by Dubai, and we had it on a branding everywhere that's Galaxy Zoom S4 Dubai. Whoever who reaches the 400th hashtag or the 400th mention with the hashtag wins a Galaxy Zoom. So you can start having competitions around the hashtag so that people make sure that they should use the right hashtag.
It's about blogging. For example, I've done some work in the past.
Yeah.
Okay, so blogging is for, if I'd done something yesterday,
mm-hmm.
I blog about it.
Mm-hmm.
What if I've done something which I've not blogged about since 2010?
Mm-hmm.
So how does it work?
Is it something which is more time specific? If it's something which is more time specific, then you can just talk about your experience and how it was, and this was something that I did, and this is what I learned out of it. And you know what, here are a few pictures, I thought I'd put this together. And take that content and put it with something which is happening right now, a bit of something which is happening right now. This is how it helped me as of today, or something around that. But it would still work. There's no time in terms of, I did this 2 years back, it does not make sense right now. But you use that more as an experience blog and say, this is what we did, this is what it was all about, put a few pictures, and you can still go ahead with it. So how many of you guys are actually planning to start your blog?
For many years.
But have you been active, completely active on a day-to-day basis?
Yeah. I have a website,
mm-hmm.
and I do put my pictures there, but want to do, and it is, I do understand it's a absolute must, have a company blog, where you actually engage with the audience and communicate, but it's so difficult to find time.
Yeah, that's exactly what, if you want to find time, there are softwares like TweetDeck, and you know, these kind of softwares where you can actually put all your social media channels on this software, so integrate it. So suppose if I just had one link of my blog and I don't want to waste time opening each and every browser, signing in and then putting this, use TweetDeck so that you can actually upload all of these links quickly. It hardly takes a minute to get the work done.
TweetDeck.
TweetDeck.
Facebook, Instagram,
all of these. It has all of these. You just put up your channels. You don't need to log on to it again and again. So as soon as you are ready with the content that you have, you just click on the channel that you want to post on and you go ahead and post it. And TweetDeck is available on iPad, iPhone, Android, your computer itself.
Even more about, everybody here has accounts in most of the things.
Yeah.
But it is about, you know, just making that effort and doing it.
Yeah, that's true. I think, initially, I'm just going to give you a very small example. If you want to lose weight, that time period till the time you actually go to the gym is much more longer as opposed to anything else. So if you really want to market this, then don't expect your 1 month to be the most rosy 1 month, because you're not used to doing this. But as soon as you see a result of what you're doing, if you got a project or if you got good reviews or if you got people to say, you know what, your work is actually good, you just need that reassurance from someone, you feel like doing it even more. But I don't think social media can be done forcefully. Social media has to be done as a lifestyle. It has to come from within you.
Once you get the taste, when you start, once you start getting engaged, and I think people do mostly Facebook because the response there is instant. You have somebody who just, you know, gives you a like or gives you a feedback or a comment, so that's more kind of personal.
I agree with you, but in a way, I feel the response on Twitter and Instagram is way faster, but only if you have already created your network. But if you have not created your network, then there will be no one to actually view the work that you have done. But again, Twitter and Instagram is more for, and Google Plus is more for photographers who take photography seriously, rather than Facebook.
What about linking the social networks, like Facebook, for example,
We never suggest to do that, for the simple reason that the way you term your 140 characters will be completely different as opposed to you writing a Facebook post with just 5 words and getting the message across. But firstly, it shows that you're linking it. It shows that you're being lazy. We can figure out in a minute that, you know, you've done this, because I'd rather just get done with it with one link. But you would rather have it different, because the kind of hashtags that you would use on Twitter would be different as opposed to Facebook. All right, guys. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Meghna.
That
was seriously informative. And we hope you take social media a little bit more seriously now. And not just do Facebook.
Yeah, I'd actually like to see it.
Yes, yeah.
Definitely.
And we have small certificate that we give to all the presenters. So from Photo Walk Dubai.
Thank you so much.
And also, I'd like to mention about one very, very much a new member of our group. His name is Abbas. Abbas, could you just, So he's from Uganda, and he read about Photo Walk Dubai when it was published in Gulf News recently.
Nice.
He called from Uganda, took the number from Gulf News, and called me, and he told, "I'll come to Dubai and I'll come to your group."
That's really nice.
So he's here today. So. Let's take maybe a 10 minutes break and fill up your nicotine level and be back. I'll be